hop-picking. Ah me, how pleasant to go down from the forlorn and faded town to Kentish wood and fold and lane, and breathe God's blessed air again, where glorious yellow cornfields blaze and nuts hang over woodland ways, to pick the sweet keen-scented hops, see from each pole a dream-wreath drops, to toil all day in pure clear air, laughter and sunshine everywhere, with reddening woods and sweet wet soil and well-earned rest and honest toil. Where do we fly under deep dark sky? Over the moors we go, over the pool where quiet and cool bulrush and sedges grow. And what was the loveliest thing we met? Ah, we forget. We remember, though, all the firelit glow of a great hearth's gleam and glare, and we looked for a space at each happy face and the love that was written there. And that, of all we have looked on yet, we least forget. Oh, what a day, all yellow and grey, and so dark, so dreary, so foggy and thick, that if I should meet in the street my sweet, I might pass her by. Risk that? Not I. Take me home out of danger then, quick feet, quick. Not summer's crown or scent the red rose weaves, nor hawthorn blossom over bloom-strown grass, nor violets whisper when the children pass, nor lilac perfume in the soft May eaves, nor new-mown hay, crisp scent of yellow sheaves, nor any scent that springtime can amass and summer squander, such a magic has as scent of fresh wet earth and fallen leaves. For sometimes lovers in November days, when earth is grieving for the vanished sun, have trod dead leaves in chill and wintry ways, and kissed and dreamed eternal summer won. Look back, through memory's deepening haze, see two who dreamed that dream, and you were one.